Hey guys, Key here from Kegland and talking to you today about Firmzillas again. Now, we've already released our Firmzilla flat bottoms. They're the new starter kit that we have and the easy, simple fermenter for guys getting into home brewing, which is non-pressurizable. We have in the past already released also our Firmzilla conical uni tanks, and they're the ones with the dump valve at the bottom so you can collect yeast and use that for purging out your hops before you do dry hopping and that type of thing. However, we also want to bring out another type of fermenter. So we've got these all-rounders, and we call them an all-rounder for the obvious reason that the base is just round. So there's no dump valve. However, it's sort of like the Firmzilla uni tanks. They've got a pressure rating to them as well. So you can use them just like a keg if you wanted to. So you could literally put a tap on here and then dispense beers out directly from this unit if you had some way of cooling it down. The other thing is you can do pressurized fermentations and take advantage of some of the benefits there. Being able to pressurize a fermenter is one of the easiest ways to ensure you're going to keep oxygen off the products. So that's really one of the main drivers for a lot of people going down the avenue of pressurized fermenters. I guess we wanted to have a product which was different from our Firmzilla uni tanks as well. The conical uni tanks are a fantastic vessel, but not everybody wants the complexity of a dump valve, for instance. It's a bit more complicated to clean out and there's more moving parts and stuff like that. And it does also add more height to the fermenter too. So some people wanted to have the ability to have a pressurizable fermenter. However, they didn't necessarily need a dump valve, or they weren't collecting yeast, for instance, that they wanted to repitch later on or anything like that. So they're a very, very capable vessel. Definitely without the cone, they're significantly more compact. So if you've got a really tight fermenting fridge or tight space, you might find from that perspective they're better. When they come out of the box, you'll find that they have the standard gravity lid that looks like this. So you can use it under gravity just out of the box. However, if you really want to get the most out of this type of fermenter, you really want to get the ball lock posts in the pressure kit. So we do have these in the engineering plastic carbonation caps here, and the floating silicon dip tube, which you can purchase separately. Or some people who prefer stainless steel, you can get also the stainless steel posts as well, the stainless steel carbonation caps which go on there. Now, the first thing you'll notice, we've got two different sizes here. We've got our Firmzilla all-rounder 30 litre. And on my right-hand side, or your left-hand side, we've got the 60 litre, the big boy. This is the biggest one we've got. It's actually getting to the limitations of what we can make on our blow molding machine, to be honest with you. So I don't think we're going to be making too many more fermenters bigger than 60 litres. So if you really want a big one, this is it. It's 5 litres bigger than our 55 litre conical uni tank. Another accessory which we started to make for this one is also this bridle, or the strap, which attaches the actual fermenter to the stand. Some people might find this handy, particularly because it makes it a little bit easier to maneuver. So if you've just got this sitting in, let's say, a fermenting fridge or something like that, then maybe you don't need to move it too much anyway, and it's probably not a big deal. You can just let it sit in the stand. However, if you want the luxury of being able to pick up the entire fermenter and move it around and still have the stand attached, definitely this strapping mechanism is kind of handy, and it does make it a little bit more ergonomical and easy to use. Another couple accessories that you might be interested in are our thermo wells that fit through the lid here, so that way it doesn't have a penetration through the body of the fermenter. And the other thing is you can also drill out a couple more of the sockets on the top of the lid so you can fit, for instance, our temp twister cooling coil if you want to glycol chill the fermenter. Thanks for that, guys. That wraps up for today. Hope you enjoy the video. If you want to hear about any of the other cool new stuff that's coming out, definitely on the bottom right-hand corner there, hit the subscribe, and that way you'll get notified of all the other stuff that's coming out when we produce new videos. The other thing is, it's worth joining our Facebook community group. So if you go onto our Facebook page, we've got that, but they've also got the community group as well. If you join that, you get to get in on a lot of the discussion with a lot of other homebrewers who are just like yourself. Anyway, I'll see you next time, guys. Bye.